Greetings, I'm Dr. Jung Jong-chul. In the upper posterior area, when you place implant along with sinus lift, while placing the implant or after placing the implant, at times the implant can migrate into the sinus. Today's lecture is going to address why such migration occurs and how to address this problem. Today, I'm going to look at the reason why the implant migrates into the sinus, the symptoms, and how to manage this problem. When you do lateral approach, at times, the implant can migrate into the sinus. Let's look at the cause. When implant is placed, the initial stability may not be good. In other words, drilling was not done properly or the bone was very soft. And as implant was being placed, it migrated into the sinus. Another cause would be the masticatory force applied to the temporary prosthesis during the observation phase. The final instance is quite rare, however, after final prosthesis is delivered and occlusion is formed, the implant can migrate into the sinus. It's quite rare, but it has been observed. In the case of this patient, the original intent was to place the implant in the upper left posterior area using crestal approach. However, on the x-ray as shown, implant has migrated into the sinus and the patient came to my dental clinic. If you look at the cause, first, the bone level in the upper posterior area is different buccally and palatally. Therefore, this may have been overlooked during drilling and implant was placed too deep. Maybe that's why it migrated into the sinus. In the case of this patient, because the bone is soft, the implant can fall easily into the sinus. As for this case, as crestal approach was taken, the implant migrated into the sinus. The patient was receiving crestal approach, the implant migrated into the sinus, and the patient came to my dental clinic. The patient was in mid-procedure. Immediately, lateral approach was done to remove the implant. In the case, bone is very soft. When you do crestal approach, if you do not make adjustments properly, it may migrate into the sinus. In this case, implant migrated into the sinus during secondary surgery. Crestal approach was done and attempt was made to place the implant. However, the bone was very soft and crestal approach was not done properly. As healing abutment was connected, implant migrated into the sinus and the patient came to my dental clinic. In the end, lateral window approach was taken to remove the implant. In the case of this patient, in number 17, during secondary surgery, the implant fell into the sinus and the patient came to my dental clinic. Immediately, lateral window approach was taken to remove the implant. As for this patient, from a different dental clinic, crestal approach was used to place the implant. However, 3 months later, when the patient came back, the implant migrated into the sinus. The patient had been using denture after implant was placed, and because continued masticatory force was applied to the implant with not good initial stability, the implant fell into the sinus like this. The patient did not come to the hospital for a long period, and on both sides of the sinus, a very serious sinusitis occurred. Lateral window approach was used to remove the implant. The inflamed tissue was removed. As you can see in the image on the right, lateral window approach was used to remove the implant. And you can see but there was a lot of abscess. It was very difficult to remove the implant, and after it fell into the sinus, it was not removed immediately. If you do not do it immediately, it's very difficult to find it, and it's difficult to remove it. Implant was in the end removed after bone graft was done. The patient was sent back to the original dental clinic. This is after surgery. Let's look at the symptoms when the implant falls into the sinus. At times, there may not be special symptoms. However, in most cases, when the implant migrates into the sinus, it can lead to acute or chronic sinusitis, and rarely, it can lead to fungal infection. Oral enteral fistula can also be formed. Therefore, when you do crystal approach or window approach, you need to do regular checkup, and if implant has migrated into the sinus, as soon as possible, you need to remove it. As for this patient in number 17 in the maxilla, crystal approach was done and implant was placed. The implant migrated into the sinus and it was left alone, untouched. And after 4 months later, the patient came to my dental clinic. Lateral window approach was used to remove the implant. However, it was very difficult because there was infection and granulation tissue within the sinus. It's very difficult to find implant position in this case. A CT was taken to check the implant position and implant was removed. If implant migrates into the sinus, how should we address it? First of all, you need to remove it as soon as possible. To do so, you can use lateral window approach or, rarely, endoscopic surgery may be necessary. The most easy and simple way is to do lateral window approach to remove the implant. After implant is removed, you need to place the implant after 3 or 4 months so that the sinus membrane becomes fully healed. When we make lateral window as we do lateral window approach, in order to remove the implant, you need to do it in the same way as doing sinus lateral window approach. When forming window, you need to make it bigger in order to remove the implant in an easier manner. You can remove it as you see it, but even if you form window, at times you may not be able to see it. If you're able to see it, you can use a forceps or Kelly to remove it. If you cannot see it, the best way is to use a suction tip. Form lateral window and insert the suction tip within the window and form negative pressure to remove the implant. In the case of this patient in number 20, the implant migrated into the sinus. Lateral window approach was taken. Because I needed to remove the implant, I perforated the sinus membrane intentionally. You need to use large size suction and insert it in the sinus. When you turn it on, with negative pressure, the implant comes out. In this case, if you're confident or if sinus membrane is sound, you can repair the sinus membrane immediately using resorbable membrane and do bone graft. You can decide whether to place the implant as you do bone graft or to wait. In the case of this patient, implant was removed, sinus membrane was repaired, bone graft was done at the same time. In this case, as crestal approach was taken, implant migrated into sinus. The bone was very soft and I think the dentist should have paid more attention, which has led to this problem. This was how the patient came in and lateral window approach was done immediately. Suction tip or forceps can be used to remove the implant. It's also the same for this case. When you use suction tip to remove the implant, there's higher possibility of sinus membrane perforation. So if possible, or if implant is visible, it is more advisable to remove the implant using forceps to avoid sinus membrane perforation. In the case of this patient, I was not able to really see it, so suction was used to remove the implant. I observed that the membrane became perforated. And in the same way as repairing the sinus membrane, I applied the resorbable membrane. I did side cutting. I positioned it, did bone graft, and placed the implant and did suture. This is after surgery. In the case of this patient, the implant fell in the sinus, but it was left untouched for over 6 months. This was how the patient came into our dental clinic. Lateral window approach was done and implant was removed. During the procedure, in the exterior wall of sinus, bleeding occurred. As mentioned, Bovie was used for electrocauterization. Bleeding was controlled and implant was removed in this way. Because there was severe inflammation, I just sutured the soft tissue. I waited sufficiently. I waited for more than 3 months so that the soft tissue within the sinus could heal completely. In this case, I waited for more than 4 months. After that, using the same method, lateral window approach was done and implant was placed. In the area where window was formed in the past, I did ablation carefully. I did bone graft and placed the implant. This is after final prosthesis delivery. At times during surgery or afterwards, the implant can fall into the sinus. This happens quite frequently. Therefore, the most important thing is to do accurate surgery and to do regular periodic checkup. If the implant has migrated into the sinus, you need to remove the implant as soon as possible. To be able to do this, you need to know the right techniques to remove the implant ahead. I believe that would help you a lot. There can be many different complications occurring during or after surgery. This can happen to anyone. And in those cases, anyone would become flustered. You need to respond to those possibilities. You need to accurately make diagnosis and place the implant in a proper way. There is little possibility, however, during sinus lift, implant can fall into the sinus quite frequently. Even if this occurs, if you know how to respond to it and how to remove it, then you'd be able to still do successful implant treatment. I hope you learned something through this lecture. Thank you for watching.